This is Dead Serious, a show about short horror stories worthy of discussion. I'm Dead Palette, and I'm reading an SCP entry, Cappuccinos. At this moment in non-time, we're going to be taking a look at SCP-1833. If you haven't seen some of the previous episodes of Dead Serious where we've been tackling the class of 76, then I would recommend starting at SCP-332, where we begin our journey into this saga. But let's get right into this one. Item number SCP-1833. Object class, safe. Special containment procedures. SCP-1833 is to be contained in a standard containment locker, located in Site-77's safe SCP wing. No personnel other than D-class personnel are authorized to handle SCP-1833. So the special containment procedures are pretty lockstock and standard for what you would expect from a object class safe that isn't in some way exorbitantly big or able to move. So whatever it is, it is easily contained. It is just a danger to society if it's out there because of its anomalous properties. And remember, object class safe just means that it is predictable in some manner. A loaded gun is safe, but it is still potentially dangerous. So the safe label is somewhat misleading on purpose because it's, you know, SCP stuff is supposed to be cutesy like that with this bureaucratic bullshit. Description. SCP-1833 is a copy of the 1976 edition blank high school yearbook. So the redacted part is quite obviously Kirk Lawnwood, right? Because that's the high school that was previously mentioned a million times. Its appearance is consistent with other copies of the book and appears to have normal wear for an object of its age. The yearbook is entitled Reflections of 76. Of Soldier 76. You didn't make the cut. It is a hardcover and contains exactly 50 pages. The book is divided into 5 sections: a collection of student photographs, photographs from around the school year, club photos, photos of athletic events, and an autograph section. So at the area where it says Reflections of 76, we are given a hyperlink to the remembrance files. So apparently the remembrance files are coming from the book itself. That includes the pictures, but I'm not so sure about the remembrance files that are either morning or afternoon announcements or the parts that seem to be third-person narratives told from a God's perspective. Not sure how those fit into that, but other than that, it seems to be your standard high school yearbook. When SCP-1833 is read by any person who graduated from high school, the object's anomalous effects will initiate. The individual, hereafter referred to as the subject, who reads SCP-1833 will perceive it as their own high school yearbook, containing messages left by persons with whom they associate socially during their high school year. Initially, these photographs and messages will be positive, with encouraging comments written in the book's margins, often mentioning events which invoke positive feelings in the subject. However, after approximately 10 pages are read, the messages will begin to come more negative in tone. Initially, they will recount events that occurred during high school for which the subject feels embarrassment or remorse. They will then begin to mention events from the subject's life that occurred after completing high school and will make personal attacks on the subject. In addition, the photographs depicted in the yearbook will become more negative, with the persons depicted in the photographs often appearing to be heavily deformed. So if I'm reading the section of this right, where it says, contains messages left by a person whom they associated socially with during high school years, that means if you read this book you will project pictures of people from your high school into the book. People whom you associated with socially. So not acquaintances, people who you were actually social with, not just like person whose name you don't know, people who you do know. And they will start off positive, but then slowly devolve into more negative content, comments left in the margins and whatnot, as well as mentioning events that you regret. So with SCP-1423, you have all of these nostalgic memories, which again, as we've talked about, nostalgia is not a positive emotion. It's a healthy emotion to have occasionally, but you have to have it in healthy amounts. But this is kind of dealing with a different thing. This isn't remembering fond memories. This is remembering negative memories. So this is kind of the opposite end of the coin from SCP-1423. And I think that that is an interesting idea. This is also reinforcing the deformed photos that we have seen captured in the remembrance section. Hopefully we will get some sort of explanation as to the final part of the remembrance files. With epilogue, the last word, where we have the three women with deformed faces, the guy with the deformed face, and the person sleeping in the bed. Hopefully we will get a little bit of context to that image. That is very haunting, but I want it to have more substantive meaning. After an intermediate number of pages have been read, ranging from 20 to 30 pages, photographs of the subject will begin to appear in the book. Initially, these photographs will depict embarrassing events that occurred during the subject's time in high school. However, as the subject progresses through the book, the photos will become more disturbing, with photographs of subjects committing suicide, being mutilated, and being harmed by other persons depicted in SCP-1833 being the most commonly reported images. So again, this being the sort of mirror image of SCP-1423, where you look at the photograph and makes you remember your last summer vacation, and then slowly replaces those memories with memories of Rusty and Cindy and Andy and Lee, their memories instead. This is sort of doing a similar thing, where it is gradually assimilating you into its reality. So you start off with the positive comments and the positive memories, but it slowly degrades into regret and remorse, and then eventually you yourself are put into the pages of SCP-1833. But let's get into some common examples. Examples of images depicted in SCP-1833. Page 3. Beginning of SCP-1833's contents. Several students, including the subject, are depicted in candid photographs taken during the school year. All persons depicted in the photographs appear smiling, and the subject is pictured socializing with large groups of attractive students. Page 10. Subjects appear to be giving a presentation to class. The topic of this presentation varies between subjects, but students observed appear engaged and interested. Reminds me of the time I gave a presentation to my fine art teachers that were going to be judging my thesis program, and I gave them a presentation on how fine art is dumb and needs to stop. Page 16. First instances of negative imagery. The subject appears to be spilling a lunch tray onto several other students. The subject appears to be doing that. So, in this instance, it is you making a social faux pas of, like, you trip, and now they're going to remind you that you did this thing that hurt other people. Page 20. Subject appears in a goalie uniform, lying in the grass as the opposing team scores a goal. A marching band is visible in the background. The marching band thing has a hyperlink to SCP-332, which is the first part of this series. But again, you're just failing at something in life, in this case being a goalie. Page 29. First instance of violent imagery. Subject appears to be in a nurse's office with several abrasion wounds on the face and neck. All right, that is interesting. That isn't something that is necessarily insidious, except for the fact that why would you document that and put it into a yearbook? That is just subtly off in the right way, and it's working for me. It's obviously off, but it isn't overt. And like you could see someone making a stupid mistake or on the yearbook committee and trying to be a dick, but it's just off just enough for me to think that it is ashcan approved. Page 36. Subject appears in a music club photograph. However, the other club members have congregated to the far side of the photo and appear to be jeering and throwing things at the subject. Page 39. The subject appears to be sleeping in its bedroom, and it's surrounded by other persons depicted in the yearbook. These persons having grossly mutilated facial features and are looking directly at the viewer. Okay, so now we are getting an explanation for this image. Back cover. Handwritten messages saying, "We've had a great year, haven't we? Don't worry about waiting for the reunion. I'm sure we'll see each other soon enough. Lots of love from all your best friends." All right, tons to talk about here, but when it says music club, it has a link to SCP-814. Now, I will not be reading SCP-814 right now. However, if you would like to check that story out and report to me on whether you think it's successful or not in the comments, I would greatly enjoy that. The next thing that we will be reading is SCP-2316, which is linked when it says, "I'm sure we'll see each other soon enough." Now, that is incredibly ominous. So the idea of, like, everything starts out positive, slowly building up the positivity, then crushing it down, slowly more negative, and then it ends with the very ominous idea of you being surrounded by people with mutilated faces while you sleep, and then culminates in the back page having this denouement, this trickling off of, "Don't worry, I'm sure we'll see you again." So, like, there's this idea of the high school reunion and everything, and these feelings about it. I'm really enjoying the idea of, like, well, you can't go back, as was mentioned a bunch of times, and remembrance, the nostalgia, the feeling of loss, and then this is confirming, like, don't worry, continue to live your life where you've lost all of that innocence, all of that childlike wonder, all of that high school optimism, and now you're living a life depressed and broken. Don't worry about that. You don't need to go back. We will come to you. And it's written in a very ominous way. So, what is going to happen in SCP-2316? I get the feeling it's not going to be something great. I already have a vague idea of what it's going to be about, and I'm excited. I hope you are as well. Now, if you enjoyed that, consider helping out the community and supporting my channel. You can support the community by conversing in the comments below and going to toospooky.com. That's toospooky.com for original horror stories. Make sure to look into Raw Dog Readings here on YouTube. They read creepy stories and analyze them, just like me. You can support me by following me on social media, links down in the description, and pledging to my Patreon, which is also down below. Thank you so much for your time, and now on to our sponsor at this non-moment in time. Fairy dust. Fairy dust. I don't know what it is, but this guy from the bathroom gave me some, and I'm feeling pretty great right now.